Deep in the bowels of a building on the outskirts of Strasbourg, classified information on criminals and illegal border movements is collected and passed on to member states' police. It's physically and legally bomb-proof, part of the intelligence exchange vital for security today. What's happening across the Atlantic, however, also in the name of security, is causing more concern here. Specifically, why and how the Americans are using the private data of Europeans.
Sorry, bugging the EU offices in Washington is a matter of national security. Blanket surveillance of millions of innocent citizens is a matter of national security. I do not buy that anymore.
The PRISM spy program of the National Security Agency was the cause of deep splits when it was debated in Parliament this week.
The European Parliament is carrying the hopes to restore rule of law and the respect to fundamental rights. Because today, in a digitalized and globalized world, the protection of those values is strongly linked to information technology.
Security services should not only protect our lives, but also our liberty. But in a democracy where you think first and act later, you gather facts before you threaten and compromise international agreements, this is totally unacceptable.
For other MEPs, the furore over personal data protection misses the point entirely on wider security.
The ones we should be concerned about, of course, are the hostile intelligence services. But of course, no one's discussing what's happening as far as the Chinese, as far as the Russians, and as far as others are concerned.
Some MEPs have asked that President Obama appear personally in Strasbourg to explain his agency's activities. At the very least, they say, they want him to stop singling out European allies.
Im Grunde müssen wir auch darauf dringen, dass unsere Bürger bei dieser Ausgangslage, die wir im Moment haben, einen viel, viel besseren Rechtsschutz in den USA bekommen, den den US-Amerikanern auch gleichgestellt.
Two things remain fixed after Thursday's vote. A committee of inquiry will report back by the end of the year, and the much-heralded EU-US trade talks will continue on track. Such are the potential benefits to both sides.